Now we will look into how we can create release APKs. So first thing that we will have to do is that we have to create a key store file. So you can simply search in Google, create release key store Android. So you can get some results from Stack Overflow or from some other places. So you can see codes like this. Key to gen key, which generate key, and which will results by creating a key store file. In this process, we will have to provide the alias, and during the process, we will have to enter such details like address, and we will have to give a password as well. So let's create a key store right now. So what I will do, I will go inside this, inside this app directory. So where this debug.keystore is already present. So I can run this command over there. And my release key, so I'm not going to change anything. And the alias name, I will change. I am dev. That's it. So I will enter some password, like I am going to use the same password, like I am dev. So first name like foo ba funny. Hard or strong. So we have successfully created the key store over here. We are running this key store. So before we are doing this, if you are doing this first time, you may face some issue because you may don't have the Java in your machine. So in that case, I want you to install Java at the first place. So you can download the OpenJDK or Oracle one, and you can install it in your machine. And you should have set the path in your machine as well. And after that only you will be able to run this kit. Okay. And now so we have successfully created the key store. Now what I will gonna do over here is that I will modify our gradle.properties over here, because see, in this one we are using a dummy name like foo-release-key.keystore. So I will change this to match with my my release key.keystore. Now my app upload key alias I will use like I am dev. I'm using the same password over here. I am dev. I am dev. So it's done. Now the thing that we are going to do is that we will simply run the command yarn clean. So I told you that we can use this command to clear the build. So if you check over here, we have lots of files is being changed because we have created a build, right? So we can clean this first. So we can run yarn clean or npm clean. It's up to you. So we have cleaned everything. Now, as I have told you earlier, we can go into the package.json file and we can look into the scripts which we have already here. So I will gonna use this one, install APK. So before using this, make sure that you have connected your phone and you are able to see this phone in the terminal as well. Why you can simply run ADB devices. So you should see your device which is attached into this machine. Okay, so my mobile phone has been connected with this machine, and so I will be able to run the yarn install apk command. So it will create a release apk and it will install it in my machine. So before doing that, we can look into some other configurations, so which I have told you earlier in the previous video. In the app level build.gradle file, you can modify this universal apk. So you can set it as true, so it will create a universal apk as well while you are creating the release builds. So let's run this yarn install apk. It will take some time, obviously you will need a good machine for that. Percentage executing. So here we are, the build was successful, and you can see that installing apk app arm64v8a release.apk. So according to my device is a OnePlus Node, so according to the CPU architecture, this is the right apk for my mobile phone. So it's being installed in my mobile phone. And if you go in the app build outputs apk and inside the release folder, now you can see here 1 2 3 4 5 apks. Why 5? The universal release.apk is being created because of the build.gradle configuration that we have added over here. Universal apk 2, that's why this app universal release.apk is being created. And we have configured this build.gradle for creating different apks for the according to the CPU's architecture. So what is the advantage of universal apk and what is the advantage of creating multiple apks? If you create universal apk, it's easy for you to transfer this apk with any other person. So you don't want to know which device that person is using, you don't want to know what is the CPU architecture of that person's device. Without knowing all these things, you can just compare the universal apk and just give to that person, and that person will be able to install it on his machine. That is one of the advantage of universal apk. And why we need multiple apks? As we are creating universal apk, the size of the apk will be higher because it needs to be installed in different CPU architecture. That's why we can create specific apks for different CPU architecture. So in this way, we can reduce the size of the apk. So if we going to open this folder, and if we can see the size of the file, if you look into the universal release.apk, the size of this apk file is around 33 MB. And what about others? Others are having half of it, right? 15, below half of it. So in this way, you can reduce the size of the apk. And while you're publishing into the Play Store, the thing that you want to do is that you only want to do, you will have to upload all these four APKs together into the Play Console. And whenever the user is going to download the APK from the Play Store, the appropriate APK will be downloaded into his device. And if you're going with the universal release APK, you can simply upload the universal release APK. So it's up to you how you want to build the APK. So this is about how to compile the release APK. So it's a really straightforward approach. You don't want to worry about most of the things because everything is being taken care in this skeleton. So you can simply, you can change the things that you want to change, or you can, whatever the things that you want to customize for your application, you can simply customize those changes only, and you can simply create your APK and you can publish it without any hassle. Thank you.